Since liberation and shifting power, South Africa faces many crises. One of the deepest being the equitable redistribution of land and that of affordable, adequate housing for all. In the town of Stellenbosch, tucked away among the beautiful winelands of the Western Cape, a town bustling with economic energy, a crisis exists of this very nature. It involves municipal land leased then bought by the Blauwklippen Agricultural Estate, some of the most picturesque real estate in the country, and a small forgotten community on the outskirts of the land, who after hearing many promises are now expected to be evicted from their homes after 20 years to another temporary relocation site, making way for private development.
The issue with this is when Blauwklippen bought this piece of land about 10 years ago, they bought it with the informal settlement on it, you know. So they knew exactly what they bought, and the municipality has never addressed the housing issue and the shortage of housing in Jamestown area for more than 20 years.
It's about 20, 21 years, I mean, to get here and to move to the 3x6 or 3x9 vendor house. I started with the 3x9 here 20 years back, so it took me 20 years to get here. So it's going to take me another 20 years to get a house like this. And then in 20 years time, I'll be 70 years old. What happened to my children?
On the 4th of October 2015, a protest march by the community culminated at the entrance of Blauwklippen Estate. The municipality were conveniently absent.
Rather not give any comment, we will do an official statement once everything is done.
It's a problem we've been addressing with the municipality for many years.
And is it the municipality that is not actually moving, in your opinion?
No comment on that. You need to speak to the municipality.
So it's not really Blauwklippen's issue, is that what you're saying? It's a problem, but it's not your issue. It's not your responsibility.
No comment.
Excuse me, they've made quite a lot of accusations over here. Your response to that?
There is not really at the moment a response to give. We have spoken a lot, and it's one way of how the people can raise their voice, which we have to accept. Yeah. We will look into the papers and we will respond in the 30 days, which we always did so far. So I'm not going in the day-to-day words that are spoken to the people. I'm looking into the whole facts, right, and taking it up from there.
And particularly the young professionals, they can't afford some of this. Okay. Because of the overemphasis and the influence of the capitalist developers who are maximum profit driven, they make it impossible for the average person to afford a house.
Asking about the political economy of Stellenbosch is an interesting question, and I don't know whether many people are actually doing the research on that. What one can do is to start asking some interesting questions about what's been going on,
right,
and maybe speculate, right, a bit about what's been going on.
As long as the people in the area are living on land which is nominally owned by somebody else, that story is going to have to get resolved.
The impact forced removals have on the social fabric of communities and the negative effect on families and individuals, like they were in the past, are massive. Yet they still exist in a country where equal rights are assumed, but deep divisions of socio-economic class exist. The right to choose where to live is greatly impeded by class brackets, manufactured by policies accepting that negative consequences are just a way of life.